What did make me happy? When I on the deck, I see the people smile, enjoy what I really give them energy, and they got my energy from my play when I touch the mixer, and really bring from mixer go to the arm, after the arm to the somehow connect to the speaker and go to them, and they get it. They get the wave from me. I am how to say, give them energy and they're happy on where I'm control them. It's really the own style Thai name actually. Siprai, it means like kind of a green jungle of herb, Prai. When I was a little girl, I live in the countryside, east of Thailand. The city called Korat have the right farm around the village, actually. We have like 50 house in the village there. So what I did before, I doing many things to find myself, actually. When I was 15, I out from the village, moved to the city, work, and study at the same time. I'm happy to make money for to support my life and not have to ask money from my parents, you know, and spend time with friends, hanging out, get to know the world. I mean that is a little bigger step on my world, actually. I work at a factory, many different factories, because in Korat, there's so many factories that are interesting to know what they produce.
When I was young, I wanted to be a beautiful
person. I didn't dream about it. I didn't have any dreams.
อยากเป็นครูอาสาที่ว่าไปสอนเด็กบนดอยค่ะ
อยากเป็นตำรวจค่ะตอนนี้ทำงานก็ไม่อยากเป็นแล้วค่ะ
ยังไม่ได้คิดอ่ะน่าจะถ้าออกจากที่นี่ก็น่าจะขายของ
ประกอบธุรกิจส่วนตัวค้าขายทั่วไป
ค้าขายค่ะจริงมาหลายรอบแล้วค่ะ
When I was young my dream is likeI want to have my own business, whatever business, because I never know that what I have talent, what I want to be, but I just want to own some business, whatever will come up in the future. And then I went to last factory. I get bored because too long see the same people, the life not interesting. So I just moved to work at the shopping mall. I work at the game shop. Sometimes have no customer, I take the coin from the shop, open the key, take the coin and put it in again, and I just dance, you know. Sticker shop, and then internet cafe.
ตอนนั้นเปิดร้านอินเทอร์เน็ตอยู่ด้วยกันกับปูเขาเป็นคนแบบชอบเปิดเพลงในร้านอะไรเงี้ยเวลาในร้านเขาจะแบบว่ามันจะมีเครื่อง MP3 อ่ะเขาก็จะเอาแบบเพลงอ่ะมานั่งต่อแรกๆเลยเขาฟังเพลงป๊อปก่อนนะป๊อปไทยก่อนแล้วก็เริ่มมาเป็นแบบเพลงสากลอะไรเงี้ยพอหลังๆมาเขาจะเริ่มแบบว่าเพลงเขาแบบเริ่มมาต่อจังหวะเพลงใส่ด้วยกันตอนที่แบบรู้จักกับเซฟเพิร์มเมเนเจอร์ของเขาอ่ะเขาบอกว่าเอ้ถ้าเกิดแบบยูแบบอยากเป็นดีเจไหมอะไรเงี้ยยูชอบยูเป็นแบบไม่ไปเป็นดีเจละเขาก็เลยแบบว่าเซฟเป็นผู้จัดการเขาอ่ะก็เลยพาเขาไปเรียนต่อเพลงอะไรเงี้ย
Nakadia I didn't really choose her it happened I used to go to Thailand in the time 2002-2003 and I found her online. Somehow I got across her profile and we started chatting and then I saw her music, her enjoying the music actually. She was working in an internet cafe and she was all the time moving, all the time dancing. So I was really impressed and I was thinking about she should work with music. I asked her if she would be interested to be a DJ and immediately she, yeah, let's do that, you know. That was the start.
So he offered me to maybe we go to Europe, the beginning, you know. I can be a DJ, but of course it's so hard to get the booking in the beginning. I don't know anything. And so, okay, I just decide to come like a 3 month visa. I'm doing a model shooting, make some money for my beginning career.
Indonesian.
Oh, okay, rice. Yeah.
Nasi.
It's your job.
But normally you can put in something more.
What we can cook
then? You know how to make it nice.
We make it spicy.
Yes,
no?
We make it spicy.
Yes. So, Spanish not eat spicy, no?
This is Indonesian.
Wow. I don't like it spicy, but it's okay.
Can we put spicy on? No?
Yes.
Yeah.
Can I ask somebody, like, when the couple work together, I think some people said it's difficult.
Yeah, very difficult.
But how about you guys?
Well, because we also, of course, discussion and fighting about more work.
She hates me, actually.
I'm like feeling like I have boss or I have second father, you know. So, well, I learned from him. I learned at the end. I also learned from you. So, I tried to be nice.
In the beginning, I was a teacher for her. Now I just work for her. It's changed a lot. She knows exactly what she wants. I cannot say nothing.
Mm. Oh, almost it's about work.
Yeah, everything is about work.
Yeah. The night that inspired me to be a DJ, I went out with Sebastian to some club in Germany. And they have special event with a superstar DJ called Marusha. In that time, she really famous, no? From the 90s. So like, wow, the DJ rocking the party, and people really come for her. And I am in the middle of the dance floor. I look at that girl. Everybody look at her, give her the face and shoot the hands up, you know. I like, wow, so cool. So that inspired me, like, hey, Sebastian, give me the idea. Why don't you become a DJ? And when I see this, yes, I will be a DJ. I decide on that night. I didn't have any idea what I want to do, what I got to do. I just want to be DJ, but I have no idea what you should begin. I don't know anything. After that night, Sebastian, I asked Sebastian, like, hey, I want to be DJ. What can I do? You know, ask him the beginning. So he bring me to the record shop. So we check the music, search the music, what style I like. That's the first step. So I bring two, I know, back to Thailand.
Hi, it's me. I'm Nakadia. And I am in Technical University of Braunschweig. This is the old building before the Second World War. And they find out about television here. But I also start to DJ here. So I will show you the sick place that I used to DJ here. So let's go.
In that time, I come back to Europe again. Because when I packed it for myself in Thailand, actually, like, not the best, you know, because I learned by myself. I don't know what it can do more. And in that time, internet is not really big, so I cannot just search on internet, YouTube, and find out how to DJ. So I just play, I get bored. So I come back to Europe again to become a real learning, practice. So I learned in the Braunschweig University because Sebastian's friend have the TV room, actually. So they put the turntable for me. Okay, this is your room, you got to stay here. Monitor, everything, DJ booth ready for me. I just play up and down, the track up and down. For 3 months I practice in university. Bye. Until the last week, I got the first booking before I go back to Thailand. The feeling of the first gig ever, because another friend from Sebastian, that he have a DJ agency. So they just put me on because that time is so new to marketing Asian DJ in Europe. So of course they would not tell to the club this is the first time Nakadia in the club. So they just tell to the the club like, Nakadia, she has 3 year experience, la la la. So they really trust, believe him. But I do my best. So the first time my flyer going around the city, like wow, really exciting, so nervous. And then in the club, 2,500 people, I perform. I getting nervous, checking, but hey, this is my I have to be professional because they tell them I have 3 year experience, you know? Okay, I have to put the needle on, you know? Sometimes feel like I don't want to check, but somehow it's checking without like this. No, why not? But then that night it's going really well, successful. I'm done. And they say like, wow, really great show, really good. Back to Thailand, and then I looking for the job. Or the club that I went to apply, actually like, yeah, I remember. I say, hi, I'm a DJ, you know, can I play your plate, la la la. And then the guy say, oh no, we have the DJ top 11 of the world. So, no, not for you. So, you know, in that time, and he poster really going around the island with the car, with the big poster going around the island. Okay, top 11. Yeah, until today, different. Nakadia poster going around. Yeah. I learned about the music step by step. And when I come to Europe, the beginning, everything new for me. I have no clue what the style of music, what is cool, what is underground. And until somehow I feel love to the quality of beat and the underground music. I really like it. And I did, in that time when I come to Europe, I make a tour, they book at me at the Asia DJ. So the club that booked me, they are not underground. So somehow it not fit in because I play for them. They also not so happy with my music, and I also not happy with them. They book me because it's a girl. Okay, I happy to get the booking, I play for them. It doesn't work, so I just move from this club. I just say bye-bye to this scene. Actually, even they pay me a really good fee, actually. I have to come to the underground electronic music. Until to 2008, that is really full time that I decide I want to go only the club that for the people really come for the music and for the DJ. So it's quite really hard to be in this scene actually. They not accept the girl so easy, come from Thailand, you be in this scene. They not accept me in that time. They really laugh about me how the girl from Thailand wanna be cool or whatever. So I do it. It's really hard. Sometimes I also need money for living. But okay, I do it. It starts from zero again. Nobody know me and my fee is nothing. So okay, I change my look totally because they look at me already, I'm not cool, I'm not underground. They see me from the outside first. They don't go in the detail that do I really can play or my music really quality. So I just change all my look, make myself so like so simple. I wear t-shirt, play, you know. I want people to see, hey, this is you come for me, come for my music. My jeans, my t-shirt, that's it. No makeup. And then, yeah, it really worked actually. They're getting accepted because it's about music, not about the look. But some people try to tell me in the underground scene, it's not about the look, it's about the music. They say it right, but they really care my look. I say, hey, why you care my look? It's about music. Whatever I look like, I'm sorry. My mother fucked me like that. That's what I think.
So what we got to do for the next track?
And to go on the top, not only just by playing, actually it's about, also not about how good you are, it's about who do you know, what connection you have, and of course you have to produce. Now today, actually, if the DJ want to get somewhere famous, you have to produce. But in that time, from the past, the DJ, just DJ, even you rock party, yeah, you can get famous from that. But today, you have to go to produce. And even you're not producer, you know, I'm not programmer. I have to work with the programmer. So it's just, and not only just produce and to bring out in the good label, big label, also to go on the top. Anyway, you have to find a way to get to the top. Yeah. But I know the way. So I know the way, so give me some time. Give me some time. Not so long.
Yeah. In 2009, a girl from Thailand rocked Reboot Festival in Eindhoven. Since then, she performed hundreds of gigs around the globe. In 2013, she will take the Reboot stage again, this time in Belgium.
It's not really usual that you have a Thai in the studio, I have to say. Not in Berlin.
Taiwan.
No, it's always it's always interesting to even musical wise to meet other cultures. Like it's a thing we have. It's pretty random in Berlin. That of course you meet a lot of Spanish or Italian people, but like I can definitely say I never made music with a Thai before. And we really enjoy it.
Me neither.
So it's always an interesting new input. And Naka comes from a completely different background than we do. So she brings completely different input into the music as well, which is very, very inspiring as well.
Because you think myself like a man, right?
No, but not because
I am a man.
No, not because it's girly. It's just it's a little bit too depressing. Maybe a little bit too deep, you know.
What? Was werden wir mal abgestellt das Sound?
I like the sound a little bit.
Aber wir können auch noch ein
drauf. I like sound more driving, more.
That's a bridge.
This track actually for my personal track, the single track actually, I'm working for the label. I would not mention the label for the moment, so we still keep it secret. The track have no name yet. We just work on the idea. We still have to arrangement and project it again. Actually, it takes many hours. Now we just begin today like 5 hours like that. So we will work one more while.
Hey, 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 hey!
When I'm traveling, I always have the new track come into my computer, so I have to prepare. Normally I play, why not I prepare the back, but now I play with tractor, so I have to prepare playlist or store the music in my playlist there. I just plan like, hey, this is for soft and hard party and emotional. So let's see, I have to read the dance form. So like, for example, this track for the main time, it works really well, it's really uplifting. Let me put. Yeah, so this track quite really, really work in the peak time. And yes, so I plan many things, just have to look on the dance floor. The emotional, I like this track. Let's see how, sometimes too much power in the track, so I need some break. So emotional. Nice feeling. So it will be really a long night. I will play at 3 o'clock to 5 actually.
but really late night. So what I do, I have some energy drink. I prepare my drink, cola, and some mixed drink for on the way. Check, 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 check. Okay. Oh, let me try first. Let's see, it's nice. Mmm, smell good. Okay, energy immediately.
The girl really hard, really, really to prove yourself. Even you good, they always think you are a girl and you play like a girl, something like that. They were like, for me, I want to prove people, hey, I'm a girl, sorry, but I play like a man. I will motherfucking rock you. Many people try to against me, of course. I think it happens every business. But you just have to believe in yourself and go for it. Like, for example, they try to block me that I got this request, and they try, then this person, also the girl actually, and they try to block me like, hey, did Nakadia la 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 talk something about me until I got canceled on my gig. That also happened. And so many talk behind, actually, I don't know, remember exactly. Yeah, but I just go for it, you know, I'm do what I'm doing. When I have a bad night, when on that night, in the morning, my sister have accident really early morning, about at 5. So, at 7, when I sleep, I close the sound of telephone. I see, when I wake up early morning, I see so many missed calls from all my family call me. I look on the iPhone, actually all the red missed calls, like, wow, what is this? Everybody from the family call me. I really, like, what is it? So I just call back to my mother, and then she say, my sister, she have accident. But then, that time I in Korat, actually the same city, the same area that my sister also had an accident. But I planned the trip already. I have to go to the next city that have to perform in that night. And in that night, I could not come to visit my dead body of my sister. And I have to perform. That was really hard, but I have to pretend like nothing happened, you know. I don't want to show people that I had something inside or behind. So I just do my best on my kick. I want to cry when I think about her. Yeah. But I have to perform to entertain people. And sometimes people cannot read that, hey, she really said, but I try to not show people what happened to me. But after that, I go back to the hotel. Sometimes I think about her, I just cry.
ดีเจผู้หญิงในประเทศไทยเหรอครับมันไม่ใช่ทางเราคือเราฟังเพลงดีเจอย่างนี้ก็จะกลายเป็นสวยๆอะไรเงี้ย
ภูมิใจเขาตั้งแต่แรกๆแล้วอะไรเงี้ยเวลาที่เราเห็นเพื่อนเราก้าวขาเดินไปในแต่ละก้าวอะไรเงี้ยเราดีใจนะ
รู้สึกดีมากมันแบบมีหลุดมาแล้วอะ
เป็นเหมือนแรงบันดาลใจให้เราได้ค่ะเวลาเราอยากจะทำอะไรเงี้ยถ้าทำได้เต็มที่และตั้งใจทำต่อมันอะมันก็จะประสบความสำเร็จเต็มที่ค่ะ
I don't think I will quit this job actually, because DJ is about the life. It's not about the job. It's about, this is my life. I can just go on and on, especially underground scene. We do because we love, we enjoy. and we cannot just stop it. It's lifestyle, like it cannot stop. My goal, I would like to play in the really big, big festival. That is my dream. My I want to get there. About my life. I'm proud what I am and I'm proud what I'm doing. Happy what I'm doing. And I'm proud that I really fighting for my life, you know, from Asia to here. It's really hard to get to here. So I'm proud that I did it, I make it to this. Of course, if I not have Sebastian support, that would be hard. More, even more hard to be here. I always think I always can be DJ. I cannot have the idea like, oh, I cannot be DJ, because I go in the right way. God give me the way.